that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
Delivered to over 200,000 civil rights supporters on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial, this speech became the defining moment of the American Civil Rights Movement. Dr. Martin Luther King dedicated his life fighting for equal rights and the elimination of racial segregation. While we have come a long way, the recent introduction of Afrocentric schools in the Toronto District School Board has made segregation a hot topic once again. The real question is, believing that the current school system was failing black youth, Angela Wilson and Donna Harrow pushed for an Afrocentered school as a way to help underachieving black youth succeed. According to statistics, 40% of black youth do not graduate, compared with about 25% board-wide. They believed that establishing an enriched African curriculum that touches on the histories, cultures, and experiences of people of African descent would help with decreasing the dropout rate. Following more than 2 hours of public submissions, the Toronto District School Board approved a proposal to create the city's first Afrocentric public school. From the beginning, the idea of Afrocentric schools was a topic of many heated debates. Many believed that this initiative was promoting segregation, while others saw it as a way of helping struggling black youth. Professor George Day, chair of the Department of Sociology and Equity Studies at the Ontario Institute for Studies and Education, believes that the TDSB's decision to have an Afrocentric school is a good idea. He argues that the current school system looks at the world through European eyes. When asked about the success rate of Afrocentric schools, Day says, "Black students at Afrocentric schools perform better on tests, skip class less often, report feeling a greater sense of belonging in their schools, and have a greater commitment to social responsibility and community welfare." Day further adds that Afrocentric schools are also a solution to high dropout rates, low motivation, teachers' low expectations, and the stereotyping of blacks. When asked if resources would be better directed at solving problems in all schools rather than creating a separate school, Day said, "In 1979, I attended a meeting of the Organization of Parents of Black Children in Toronto. The parents were speaking about the school system failing their children. In 2009, parents are still talking about this. It was time to try a new approach." Cody Severo takes a different stance on this issue in The Gateway, official student newspaper at the University of Alberta. He argues that Afrocentric schools just reinforces differences and undermines multiculturalism. While the Toronto District School Board may have the best interests of black students at heart, such a move clashes with the concept of multiculturalism. Assigning a specific school to students of a certain ethnicity accentuates differences and serves to divide rather than integrate. While advocates in favor argue that these schools will decrease dropout rates, Severo argues that it's questionable how exactly Afrocentric schools are supposed to help black students. He adds, "What they're actually doing is spitting in the face of black students and implying that they collectively aren't competent enough to acquire an education without being surrounded by racially tailored programs." Thinking that an Afrocentric school will solve dropout rates is nothing more than wishful thinking, he says. While lumping blacks together as a homogeneous group separate from all other ethnicities does more damage than good to everyone. After listening to Day and Severo weigh in with their opinions on Afrocentric schools, I decided to ask members of the public for their opinions on this controversial subject. Here's what they had to say.
I'm not for it. I think it segregates people. It's going to isolate them. Yes, in the short term, they may feel more comfortable, but in the long term, when they go out in society, they're not going to feel included. I think it's going to have the opposite effect.
I think people should all be allowed to mix, because like when you mix, then you get along better with other nationalities, and this world will be a better world for people than if they could all mix, be like one, you know, enjoy each other's races, whatever.
Cool. The children are happy and it is successful because their grades are improving. What is immoral about this?
If they have an African school, what's wrong with it? You know, they get to study together and they get to learn about their own history. And there's nothing wrong with that.
It is promoting segregation because it's not just, because you guys are creating separation among kids now, right? Because just not only the black kids who can't study, it's other people who can't study too, right? Now, because of this, it's going to be division between the kids and the races now, just bringing the old times back.
I don't think it's good for for the race. Nowadays, we definitely need to bring different culture and learn different culture compared to separating different races.
No, I think it's okay, but it's. I think I look at it as a stepping stone towards segregation again, and also Black history, that's great, but I think everybody should learn about that, not just Black people.
With the Afrocentric school students, you know, they're not going to feel that somewhat kind of pressure as they're not competing against students of the same ethnic background as, I mean, of a different ethnic background than what they are.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that in itself would actually help out, and I mean, with the support, students would have the ability to achieve their goals and reach their potential.
I'm actually against Afrocentric schools because I think it does promote segregation, and I don't think it will decrease dropout rates at all.
Are Afrocentric schools promoting segregation, or in place to help Black youth advance? No matter whom you ask, opinions will differ. I agree with the TDSB's decision to take action and try to reduce dropout rates amongst Black youth. However, opening an Afrocentric school is not the answer. There is no evidence showing that a higher percentage of Black students graduate high school. Although Afrocentric schools appear to separate Blacks from other ethnicities, I feel that labeling this a form of segregation is not accurate either. The word segregation implies that one is being isolated from a group involuntarily. Truth is, these schools are open to any student and is the student's choice should they wish to enroll. Despite all the controversy, recently, the inaugural Grade 3 class of the Afrocentric Alternative School significantly outperformed both the board and the province in this year's EQAO results. While this is one small victory, there are many more to be won before the public fully embraces these specialized schools.